Yes, good morning and welcome to you. Welcome to you, my listener and correspondent, caller, texter, and the silent one also. Yes, today is Tuesday, 18th of November, and we are here at New Start 93 FM Studios on the Mona campus of the University of West Indies, heard all over, even in a compound town. The latest news is that a radio station license has been granted, a local radio station license, I don't think it will be broadcast all over Jamaica, but maybe it will, has been granted to the community of the Maroons up in a compound in St. Elizabeth. I think it's going to be named Abeng Radio. Abeng 88.7 Radio. Anyway, we're broadcasting here from the studios of New Stock on the Mona campus here of the University of West Indies, heard all over. My name is Jerry Small, your host. Thank you very much. Well, now, you know, I suspected long ago, my mind told me long ago, that the KSAC, the Kingston and St. Andrew Corporation, back the police when they take away the goods of the produce and goods, you know, both ground food and other kind of food and goods, different kind of manufactured goods, from supposedly illegal vendors. Some of the vendors are vending in areas that they're not supposed to vend in, and it is therefore illegal. Some of them are, it's not proven whether they are vending in illegal areas, but police regularly, and police and other people, police and corporation people and all different kind of people, seizing goods and produce food from these vendors for years. And my mind told me long time that the KSAC backed the police in doing these things illegally. Because my understanding is that it's only on a third offense of a particular person vending in a non-vending area that the law enables an order to be made for their goods to be seized. And no KSAC person or individual police can't take that line. Not supposed to take that line of the man. But long time they might take with people things that kind of way. And it has been exposed and demonstrated by the acting public defender that police not only been taking away people goods and not returning it illegally, but the public defender has demonstrated that police have been handed over some of the goods to the KSAC, must say Poor Relief Department, to help feed poor people and homeless people. Handing over some of the loot. Not all of the loot them hand over, you know. They hand over what they feel to hand over. They keep what they feel to keep. Just like some people out at the airport. You have people from decades ago working out at airport customs who take orders from business people and all different kind of people. So what, you want a VCR, you want a video recorder, video player for your TV? Alright, by next week I can get one coming through the customs, seize it from the people them are bringing it in, and I will sell it. I bring it come my yard, deliver, or you come pick it up on my yard. Years now them kind of business are going through customs and all them kind of things. Same way, so you have police take with people goods illegally, even up to motor car and even up to house too, and millions of dollars take with people goods illegally and go share the loot with other people and sometimes sell the loot to other people. And the KSAC is backing the police, taking away people goods illegally and accepting these goods from police, claiming to them up go feed poor people with the Poor Relief Department. You know, say a lot of those goods going to end up in the KSAC. Some of the KSAC people them, whether a counselor or other people who work with KSAC, the best of the planting and the best of the different things going to end up in a for them car trunk on the way to for them yard. As well as some might reach the Poor Relief Department. So what this is, how they divide the poor against the poor. You take away poor people goods, say you seize it, and then you take some of it and feed some of the homeless people, and then now you get support for that, because you say you feed poor people. And this is typical way of politicians use the poor against the poor. Not only politicians do it, you know. You have other powerful people do it, but they are usually organized and are schooled in it and coached in it by politicians. You have rich people do it, and all rich people are not bad. And you have powerful people do it, whether it's police, soldier, or other people who have different kind of power. People who can overpower other people do a lot of these kind of things. The next thing, they will be handing over some of the goods and the produce to the homeless many experiencing at the Shoemaker Gully up in New Kingston. When them seize goods from people downtown, them carry off some of it up there, up at the Shoemaker Gully, where the whole homeless homosexual males live there by the hundreds, and they will be sharing it with them in order to, you know, be showing some kind of charity or some kind of care for some of the other youth that may live homeless. And in that way, them kill two birds with one stone and get the popularity of these youth. Because you know them rely on the popularity of these youth a lot, you know. So we'll tell you some more about that. And the commissioner of police, when inquiry was made what him feel about him police officers seizing goods from people illegally and disposing of it instead of handing it back over to the people after either court case or something else, commissioner of police refused to comment, saying him need more to be updated. And him is one of the top intelligence officers in the police force for years, and him is acting like he don't know about it. I mean, I forgot to study the situation. He must be aware of it, just as he is aware of his extra protection when I get the China citizens all over Jamaica, especially downtown and upon the highway construction. I'm talking about this homeless, the homeless men experience up at the gully there, up in New Kingston. You know that is a big attraction. It's a big attraction. What the fuck is a tourist attraction? Hundreds and thousands of people make sure to pass by that gully there, whether day or night, just to see the assembly and the display and the behavior and the phenomena of those hundreds of male homosexual young. Some of them not so young, some of them tough back. Some of them back tough by now. Not trying to disparage them, but not some of them going on like some gay little teenage girl, but some tough back. Some of them are some tough back, man, all 40 yard. But it's a big attraction. Hundreds and thousands of people make sure pass there every day to see them and to see them behavior. Some people wait till they're going home from work and then make sure slow down and take a look over there. Some people look when they're going to work. Some people going shopping in New Kingston or them going to the British Embassy. But from them know that going passing that year, they make sure to. They have heard about it before, never seen it. They make sure to look over there and get the experience, the homeless men experience. And it's a big tourist attraction. Tourists know about it. Foreigners who live in Jamaica know about it. And any other foreigner in Jamaica who don't know about it, some of the foreigners who live in Jamaica say, okay, I'll take you there one day, I'll drive past there, or maybe we can walk past there and see them. And yet them say Jamaica is a homophobic society. So Jamaica people hate homosexuals and we kill homosexuals. And yet they are there by the hundreds living openly in the Shoemaker Gully. And all types of them. Some of them say them is law-abiding. Some of them is delicate. Some tough. And some carry out robbery. All different type. You know, in every community, all different kind of type. But, It's a big attraction. Can be compared to how many experience. Big attraction. Matter of fact, the housing trust, that gully lead right down to housing trust, you know. So don't be surprised if you know, you're the housing trust decide to bail them out. Bail them out and set them up somewhere else and give them some compensation. And it's soon turn a heritage site, because it's already, as I said, it's already a local tourist attraction, local Jamaican people. Even people who come from country make sure, say, before them leave town, they must drive around New Kingston and take in them boy there. Whether it's day or night, you see them. Big attraction. Matter of fact, I am one then. Is this community the latest socialist garrison? Is this community the latest? So, because they have so much protection. How much time police go there and can't get them out? The police think of Tivoli this, no? You think you can go invade them, the boy there, and do them and get them out, so? They have some big support. Big support is a big garrison. So, I think it probably is the latest socialist garrison. Right now, Migla, right now, Migla, New Kingston there. And enough protection. Coincidentally, the councillor for the area, who them say, them and she not get on so good. She not doing as much work for them as how she could do. Is the daughter of the head of the housing trust? The daughter of the head of the housing trust, Easton Douglas. But them say the MP do more for them. The MP do more for them and more favorable for them. But it look like it's a big socialist garrison. And growing. And you know them have a whole lot of international support. All documentary make about them going abroad. A whole lot of documentary make about them. Film crew come from foreign, come film them there. Anthony Bourdain, what name? Anthony Bourdain. You so see him go have dinner with them and televise and all them kind of way there. Dinner and drinks after dinner. Because society, you know, them is a part of a big society. And a lot of support. I hear people talking about Jamaica is paradise. And all them kind of way. As I'm going to hear that talking. You know. Yeah, people are talking about Jamaica paradise. Jamaica paradise. And, yeah, Jamaica have some very nice aspect about it. Especially geographical. And some of them social too. A lot of nice aspects about Jamaica. Geographically and socially. But people just talk and little thing come out of their mouth to sound poetic. And that's how a lot of books have been written over the years, thousands of years, and little more we regard them as history book and historical accounts. And not historical, some make-up story. Some of them have some grains of truth in them. But a make-up story. And, you know, all around the world through the centuries, a lot of big claims have been made by different people, because this is one of the ways that people bolster themselves and boost up themselves, you know, by making claims. Matter of fact, when people reach empty land, even sometimes when people reach land that people are living in it and occupied, people come, they come claim it too. People claim empty land. People claim, you know, like how you have a claim, like gold, you say gold over there, say you go stake your claim, you go drive a stake down the earth. Put your name on it and go register it to the government and say, me claim yourself, you know, me first richer, and me claim yourself. And eventually the government might give you authority and say, all right, that a euro. They make a claim. So it is, people make all kind of different claims about themselves, about them family, about them neighborhoods. We are the baddest, we have the best football team. We are the greatest singer in the world, or we are the greatest hunter in the world. Some community and some nation claims that them are the greatest lover in the world. Them are the, you know, a lot of claims are made. And sometimes people build up their moral this kind of way by making claims and then trying to live up to the claim. Sometimes them overwhelm other people by making claims because all the other people believe it. People come down, come make you know. White people come down, come make you know. Say. We are the most beautiful people in the world and you are ugly, black, your nose broad. And you're black and your head kinky and you can't be pretty like us. We are the most. And a lot of people are overwhelmed by these kind of claims. The claims of other people to be superior. If you don't strengthen yourself, if you don't have a philosophy of life. And what is the meaning of life? And what is the meaning of you in life? What do you mean? What are you good for? If you don't have a strong concept of what you good for and your value. And if you don't know, say, the creator. And life is in you, the same creator inside you. You will be easily overwhelmed by other people's claims. And other people will claim that they're stronger than you. People claim that they have a right to this part, piece of land more than you. People claim all kind of things and you believe, because you're weak. Them have a strong philosophy. You have a weak philosophy. You just bow up. Some people all claim that you were destined to serve me. Some people are born to rule and some people are born to serve. Well, I am one of those born to rule and you must serve me. And you hear them big claim and you hear it so much. And you believe it. Sometimes because the horse or the person ride look better than the donkey where you have. That alone make you bow down to them. People are bow down to other people because of the horse where them ride or the car where them drive. And the claim where them make. You have people bow down to people all because of the dog where them have. That's why I say when sometimes some people have some little shih tzu dog and some little poodle dog, them feel bossy. Then roll on all them car window, them no want to hear you again. Roll on the car window so they can see them little shih tzu because the shih tzu giving them prestige. Imagine, people dog giving them prestige, making them into aristocrat. Your little dog with them flea. Your dog with them flea and him and all kind of little diseases him have, giving you prestige. But these things is claims, you know, and some other people, sometimes you the idiot making the claim, start to believe the claim. Your children believe the claim. And your family start believe the claim over many generations. And then other people believe and bow down to you. Because they don't have a sense of self-worth and they're not making any claim for themselves. But that's what Marcus Garvey was about. When Marcus Garvey decided to encourage the African people in captivity and in subjection and in injustice by making them know, say, you can get up and you can reach up. You're mighty race. You're not mighty now, but you have the potential for might inside of you. Not maybe, you know, not might be. Not might be, must be. That is real might. Must be and can be. So Marcus Garvey tried to encourage his people by making some claims for them, staking some claims up you mighty race. You can achieve what you will. You can achieve what you will, you know. And it is still true. It's still true. And it's still some things that some of our people, not all our people going to live up to it. But some of our people going to live up to these claims and make them real. You understand me? So there are some of our people who know that we must be a mighty people in terms of mighty in success, mighty. And strong in success, it can be made and it must be made. It can be made. In the midst, even in the midst of the captivity and the capturing that is going on now. Even in the midst of the coup that is being carried out by the ruling party along with China to capture Jamaica in a coup. Even in the midst of that, you can determine that regardless of who the latest seizure of freedom here, you going to build your might, you along with other people. You alone can't do it. But you make the decision by yourself, in yourself. And you be mighty. Mighty in success. Mighty in moral. Mighty in the distinguishing between right and wrong. And the things them that you choose. Mighty in the choosing of the habits that you're going to cultivate amongst yourself. Mighty in the care of your children and prosperity, success. Limiting the rate of birth of your children, that it mustn't go ahead the ability to take care of your children. So you're going to build up some mighty providence and provision for your children before them come and keep it in check and build yourself as a mighty people. Yeah, man, there's no doubt about it that there are some of us who are on that mission and will not be turned back under any circumstance. And these are the claims that we make for ourselves that will protect us against the claims of other people. Imagine people go and claim them better looking than you or your hair and nice and convince you now to start buying false hair and decorating yourself with false hair, fooling up your man, make you look nice with a long false hair, make you look nice with all different kind of things. You're padding up your bottom with some cloth or some sponge and it's not you. Because somebody else convince you that you don't look good. No, man. We're going to recover from all of these things. Let's hear from Justin Hines and the Dominoes. Mighty Redeemer. Straight up.
Oh, Mighty Redeemer, run from the sea. Oh, can we move?
Welcome to Straight Up. I'm your host, Jerry Small. Hello. By the way, you know that the people in the National Housing Trust, some of them, the board members, start to resign. But you know that the government want them to hang tough, include the Civil Servant Association head. The Civil Servant Association, them should, unless the whole of them agree with it, because you know the Civil Servant will get more benefit out of the Housing Trust more than the poorer people. But them headed somebody where more want please the government. That's why the JUTC issue. That's why I'm the drawback out of the JUTC. No surprise at all. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Yeah, good morning, Jerry.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah, Jerry. Sumal.
Yes, sir.
And good morning to all our listeners, both in the Caribbean and around the world, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Big up to all of them who listen to Newstalk 93 FM right here in Mona, in Jamaica.
Yeah, you are in Mona.
It's radio station is in Mona.
Yes, sir.
Newstalk 93.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I get to understand that over the weekend, those guys up at the Trafalgar Park there.
Up at Shoemaker Gully?
Yeah, they rob a JLP. You know what I hear about it?
Rob a JLP person who was coming from some conference?
Yeah.
They think it's because them is a JLP, but they rob them.
No, I am not saying because they the JLP, but I hear that a JLP man was robbed.
A woman? It was a woman, I believe.
I don't know if it's a woman or a man, but it was in the Star.
Yeah. And what result?
What the result?
Yeah.
I didn't read it, that was passing.
Some of the JLP crowd out here gathered back there after the news spread.
Yeah.
Gathered back there and there was a confrontation.
Yeah.
You never hear that?
Yes, I hear that they burn up some of the thing where they sleep on.
Eh? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So up they coming like a garrison. Eh?
Yeah, so like a garrison thing, you know?
They look how much time police go up there and can't get them out.
And the police treat them better than now than going to the ghetto, you know?
Yes, man, they treat them better, man.
Yeah. Because them homosexual big. Big no. Organization.
Yeah, they have a lot of support, international and local, so you don't just get them out like that.
Yeah, man. We're starting knowing that a man could try to turn himself in a woman.
So why you make that trouble you?
It don't trouble me.
What you talking about? You say you're sorry to know that, how that trouble you?
No, you know, if you see a man have sense and turn himself in a woman, And is that a mad person, you know?
Then why trouble you? Don't it leave more ladies available for you to approach?
Why, man, I tell you. But talking this and talking that.
Yeah.
In Africa, I hear news coming out of Africa.
Yeah.
That a lady wearing a mini.
Yeah.
You know a mini is a short skirt?
Yeah, short.
Yeah. Grab her and beat her.
Some man in a Kenya.
Yeah, some man in a Kenya.
Strip off her clothes and beat her up.
Yeah, man, beat her.
Yeah.
That's she doing herself unconsciously.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, that's the condemned to you, know, man.
Yeah, foolishness, backward.
Some idiot do that, man.
Backward. You know, so from 1968 in Ethiopia, same thing that happened. Some woman wear some miniskirt in the university. And some Ethiopian student, a riot take place in Addis Ababa, you know, because them riot against the miniskirt and all them kind of thing. And the emperor forget it under control, you know.
Yeah.
Not that him promoting miniskirt, you know, but him I say that's not the way, and you know.
Yeah.
It was a university student, them were leading you things, so the student, them would have more promoted.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, yes, sir.
Come on, look at my brother.
Thank you very much. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up, hello.
You're the king. King Jerry.
Yes, I walk on.
Oh, yes, a big brother.
Fine, thank you.
You want block a sound from this homosexuality business, you know.
Go on, man.
We need to look on it from another angle again, you know, and I haven't heard many people talk about it, but from it's something that is prevalent in my mind.
Yeah.
This thing looks more like a chemical thing, you know, and this is what the people need to worry about. These men are let out negative chemicals in the atmosphere, and it's actually changing the sex of fishes and frogs in the water. And a lot of this stuff is being pointed straight at the root of plastics.
Of what?
And the
release plastic.
Of plastics. The
plastic.
Plastics. When the plastics get hot, certain negative chemicals are released into the substances that we consume.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So this thing, the way this thing has blown up on us now, right now, what I would love us to do, instead of turning on these other victims of the oppressive system that we're living under, and I've tried to not see the problem, we need to see if we can get them to detox or something. Let them see us maybe eat something chemical rather than the spirit in them is female. Because this is what's going on now. We need to, like I said, approach it on a different level.
Hold on there. So you want them to detox?
Yeah, man. Detox and clean out and see if maybe it's something to do with the chemical reaction.
So you...
That makes more sense to me, you know, because the way this thing will blow up all over the place, man. And like I said, scientific research is pointing us in the direction of the these chemicals being leached out into the food that we eat.
But you said that already. You said that already. Hello. You said that already. It don't make a sense to go over the same thing, saying the same thing over and use up the whole item.
Well, you know, with the way the minds of the people are work, we have to keep repeating. That's the way them here, you know. That's the way lessons are learned. You're the teacher, my brother. So, that's all my block of sound on right now. In regard to certain things and certain people coming to do certain things, I'll do my best to make sure that they manifest, yeah, King?
When you say certain and certain, I don't know. The more you say certain, the more I'm uncertain what you're talking
about.
I'm uncertain. Let me express myself, man.
One love, man.
Let me express myself, man. I said, the more you say certain and certain and certain, the more I'm uncertain what you're really talking about.
Yeah, man.
All right, cool. Yes, sir. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Morning, Jerry.
Yes, Garnet, what go on?
Yeah, I know. Ras Astabla.
Yes, sir.
You know, so I'm not fight him.
No, but I know that you think you are him general secretary. Are him his own general secretary?
My own everything.
Yes, I hear that he have an internal dispute amongst himself, you know. Mm. You know?
No, I'm never hear that one.
An internal dispute amongst himself.
Yes.
But that is for sure how great him is. Yeah, go ahead.
Him has said some solid things from the other day.
Yeah.
And you know, say the first time him talk about why out of many wouldn't make it was on your program, you know.
I wouldn't be surprised.
No, but you end up have to save him from himself.
Oh.
Because right as him done tell you why, say the white people, them not really interested in us see where them poor parents do.
Yeah.
And my name him start to turn pan that you have to cut him off.
Oh yes.
They don't know, said him, the call immediately after him now was seen Parry. They pan my case again. But me not fight him.
Which Parry that?
Eh? Asta Black of a Parry, man.
Yeah, just describe. Tell me a woman. Me must know.
You know, say you know, are you make me know him. Because one time him... Asta Black called to and him come on right after he said, Asta Black send you for call. Alright, you remember the man where he did that tell, say, he must say him hear me up a cliff you that about bail out.
I know Mr. Sanguinetti.
No, man.
Oh.
Copyright your thing them because...
Mr. Fox?
No, man. Well. Him is a no name.
Oh.
He have no name for the program.
Oh.
But really, Asta Black tourism and tourism marketing, you see?
Yeah.
Asta Black know that.
Yes, they know it, they know it.
Can't take that from him.
No, and him know media.
Yeah. But my difference with him is this going round in every election. Well, him, according to how him explained it this morning, he say marketing.
Yeah.
But me, I say, Asta Black had done household name
already, yes.
In Jamaica already. So this going round in every election now.
Yeah.
May I say it would have preferred I concentrate on a constituency and try for Billy.
Yeah.
I don't know, but him feel say me a fight him. And no. The only thing with me, my difference with him is that he's going round in every election.
Yeah, but you said that already. Listen here now.
Yes.
Is he open for membership?
Why, I don't know.
Well, that's why I must find. So Andrew is open for membership. And then you see if him want membership, because what I find is the majority of my brethren, especially in the Rastafari movement, most of those who put forward themselves, them say representing, and I talk as of like, you know, most of those who put forward themselves, say them are represent Rastafari, is self-appointed people, and then to make matters worse, they are self-appointed for life.
Yeah.
They don't report to anybody, they're not accountable to anybody else except government.
Yeah.
They report to government, they report to big, other big official like Mike Henry and other people, but them not report to the mass of the people, not accountable. Thank you very much, Ghani.
Thank you, sir.
Let's go for a break.
News Talk 93 FM, heard everywhere.
Yes, we welcome you listeners, you callers, you texters. Good morning, welcome.
Good morning, Jerry.
Yes, sir, welcome.
Morning. A lot of people say you are idiot, but honestly, I listen to you. You know, some just laugh after them. You hear my problem, no? You see, me about the land business, eh?
Yes.
But what happened, a lot of us in our country, we have land out there, but the people them dead.
Yes.
Me contact a lawyer, the lawyer said the land, they have to go administrate on the land, them.
Yeah.
Before we can get documents.
Yeah.
So, me don't like somebody from the government side can call, come on your program and tell us how we can get through, because the administrator land takes years before it comes through.
What the name of the land administrator, what the proper name for the land administrator and name again?
I don't know, you know, but we are in, enough people. We have 100 persons in that area.
Which area is that again?
Tulane, Lower Tulane, Higher Tulane. Not Tulane.
Yeah.
One of them dead. And we say, but they have left them to pay for the administrator.
Yeah.
But we have there.
I'm going to ask our producer here to write down that. So let us get somebody from the lands department.
Yes,
to help straighten out for us how people can get. How people can get their land or their claim administered in a way that them can get back them title.
To pay taxes. If we can get to pay with taxes until then they come through, you know?
Yeah.
And the other one again, Jerry.
Yeah.
From last year, December, you see?
Yeah.
A man had some chicken from me. I'm going to kill 100 pounds of chicken. They have a side problem.
Yeah.
I'm going to go deliver to him, Jerry. And yeah. The man will recommend him to me. If it maybe get 16,000, the man will recommend him to me. Him pay me 14,000. And until now, the man still owe me $2,000. Every minute I call him, and he never called me one day. And all them tell me say he might call somebody from foreign and get money from.
Yeah, he's not going to call you and beg you to come collect the money now. You have to get somebody who will go with you to collect your money and don't stop.
My wife, the last week Saturday, my wife called me up to Saturday. Intel she will get it Monday. And she did choose it. This man may call him and tell
yes,
him.
Yes, but listen here now. Listen here now. You see your problem there?
Yeah.
These are common problems, and people will do. Most people will do whatever you allow them to get away with. So you have to just make up your mind before that you're not going to get away with this, and just make it as cheap as possible for yourself that it don't cost you more driving to collect it more than how much you have for you. But it's a common problem. Don't be down at it. But thank you very much.
No, I
sympathize with you. I sympathize with you, but hold on strong. Thank you very much. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Hi, good morning, Bungle Jerry. How are you?
Welcome, thank you.
Yesterday morning, in the news broadcast with Errol Lee.
Yes, sir.
He mentioned the discrimination practiced by the Ministry of Labor against HIV applicants for the overseas work program.
Oh, yes.
Of course, it got lost with the out-of-money experience discussion.
Yes.
But I was looking at the significance because regular employers could discriminate against ordinary workers. in the workplace if they were to follow the same policy of the Ministry of Labor.
Yeah.
And I think that this is something that we need to revisit and look at.
Yeah. Now, the discrimination, does it consist of asking people or demanding people medical record to see if they are HIV positive and therefore excluding them from the program?
I think that is what the newscast said, that they did some blood tests. And what the ministry did was that they would have excluded them without even bringing that to their attention, that was the reason why they were not employed on the program. But as I said, it was broadcast yesterday. I think it was in your 7 o'clock news in the morning.
I remember seeing it in print and seeing a picture of people at the Ministry of Labor applying for farm work tickets and things. But from when I was a little boy, one of the screening measures that the Ministry of Labor usually utilized when screening people for farm work was testing them for venereal disease. And from my memory, accounts that I heard from people is that whoever had signs, the physical signs are the test results of venereal disease were excluded. Sometimes they were embarrassed in front of the whole crowd. I remember stories of people being embarrassed and bawled out and information being revealed to the whole crowd there when people went back for the results. But I can't make up my mind whether I think that people... it's not that I can't. I have not yet made up my mind whether I think that people who are HIV positive should be excluded from such programs because... this is an extra burden on the country where you're going to and a risk that is being taken admitting it here. I don't make up my mind yet whether I agree with it or not. I can't say that I disagree with it.
Yeah, but my concern too is that at least we need to have a discussion about it.
Because, yeah, it would be good.
In the context of medication what is available.
Yes. All right, just quickly, in 30 seconds, what is your opinion about it?
I think that it goes against the constitutional right of the person for work.
Constitutional rights, but
the right to work.
Yeah.
That is what I'm concerned over.
The screening by the Ministry of Labor that is being referred to, is it about employment overseas?
Yes.
Well, the constitutional right for you to, I don't know how much constitutional right you have to go into another person's country and secure work. I don't know if it's a constitutional right. In Jamaica.
But in the context that I don't think it is a requirement. Well, as I say, I'm not too familiar with...
Yeah, can we talk about this?
Employers.
Can we talk about this when we have more time?
Yes, another time.
Call me again. Not too late.
Attention because, as I said...
Yes, thank you very much. I appreciate that. We need to think about it. Good morning. Welcome to Straight About It. Hello?
Yes, man.
Welcome, sir. Wagwan.
Welcome, man. What am I on? Well, I'm here eating my breakfast from my aki tree, green banana, running back of my yard, and the vegetables.
Yes, sir.
But the swordfish now come from abroad. I'm glad to
eh?
Yeah, man. But everything on my backyard, eh?
Yeah, lucky dog can't climb tree.
Anyway. Yeah, this now, Jerry.
Yeah.
According to what Wilson said, and you know it too, about these religious thing, a man, a beat man, and take off people's clothes and things because
yeah.
of religious.
Yeah, miniskirt, yes.
Yes. Now, look at the page D8 of Sunday's Gleaner.
Yeah.
Yeah, this now, Jamaica to host Festival of Religious Freedom.
Yeah.
And that comes January 24th. And then next year.
Yeah?
No, what a privilege you have in this country, and people can talk about the Jamaica, but Jamaica was that another thing that they have it worldwide.
Yeah.
And Jamaica have it next year.
Yes.
You saw we, you know, and a man can't go to church now, you can't put on my clothes and go on fasting now.
Yeah.
Tonight, tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday, any day, and I'm going to trouble you.
Yeah.
So when we done that, cause Jamaica. Jamaica a good place.
Yeah, who cause Jamaica?
But you do it all the way.
Me? Voila, what me say? How many cost Jamaica? Tell me.
By costing the people.
What? No, tell me. Repeat one of the sentences.
No, man. I'm not here to tear you down.
No, man. But no. Just tell me one of the sentences. Where?
I'm not get you down.
Where I condemn Jamaica?
No, I'm not tear you down. I'm not tear you down, man. I'm not tear you down.
What me not vex?
No, a bit.
Eh?
I'm not tear you down, Jerry.
No, but a general shipyard use for me.
No, man, you know what I'm going already. I'm not do it.
No, yeah.
See again.
Yeah.
This thing about this religious thing, where come on, here, which part of Guinea come from now? It came on the, I'm telling you, the section.
No, tell me about it first before you tell me the section.
No, so it's section the of the Guinea.
Tell me about the thing, man.
No, but this thing should come at the front page.
Oh, you mean about the big the festival next year?
Yes, man, because...
Well, by next year. By next year, it will move up. Take time, move up.
It's coming front page.
It will take time, move up, man.
Yeah, but to have certain things, man, must come rear front, man, up front.
Up front. Yeah.
Yeah, man. And again, last thing now.
Yeah.
You ever... Now you're not working right now, but who looking job? You ever look... My name is Carla, which is a paper. Everybody go, hey. If they want a Mason, if they want a Mason, and say, hey, Mason.
Yeah.
Look at you, you know?
Yeah.
If they want a dressmaker, hey, dressmaker. Everybody want to use AA and go up front for them name come.
Yeah, yes, you're smart. Why you're smart? You're smart. But then some people use them brains, man, and you. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. May I go to the next? No, may I go to an A call?
Okay.
Right, another call. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Morning, sir. Sir.
Oh, yeah, Carl Wilson.
Well,
go ahead, man.
Wilson. May I have two things to talk to you about. The one with the taxis.
Yeah.
With the land down in Manchester, they say.
Yeah.
And
Killani.
The other one now with the man who is telling you about human rights.
Yeah.
The job. The screening. If you want somebody to work with them like a company,
yeah.
Then you screen them to see if they have police or criminal record.
Yeah.
Or if they're healthy.
Yeah.
You know, just take man come in you know, your company. If you go over that, the next thing you see, sit down when you check a man will have all sorts of disease, suffering from all sorts of disease. You check to see if the person is physically fit.
Yeah.
Not true?
Yeah.
Okay. Wilson, now, in a double IAS of him, the nomenclature, you know.
What I mean?
Wilson Information System.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Well, this guy, you know, who has been paying, has he been paying the taxes?
I don't know him say it don't seem like it's like I'm Samuel one
start. No, Chulani, I mean Chulani. Chulani.
Yeah, Samuel one.
The administrator general.
Yes.
Only administers and land that the people somebody died and leave.
And don't leave no will.
And don't leave no will. Intestate.
Yes, intestate, yeah.
So he has to be paying taxes for at least 12 years.
Yes, I know that.
Unmolested, you know.
Yes. Not paying taxes unmolested. Paying tax for 12 years and occupying the land unmolested. Nobody try and move him.
Yes.
And at the same time paying the tax.
And when the matter goes to the court to be adjudicated,
yeah.
He must make sure, say.
Receipt.
No, outside of the receipt. He must, then we'll put it in the green after 12 Fridays.
Yes. But look here, thank you very much for the information. Come back again after the news, because vital.
All right, okay. Good.
Thank you very much. 10 a.m. headline.
Good morning. With the latest headlines, I'm Kayla Wright. Opposition spokesman on local government, Desmond McKenzie, is demanding that the Police High Command urgently implement recommendations on the keep and care of goods seized from vendors. In a special report, Acting Public Defender Matunda Makulu yesterday reported that his probe has found, among other things, that the police have been illegally seizing the goods of vendors and handing over the items to state entities. Makulu had launched the investigation following complaints by vendors in downtown Kingston. According to the Acting Public Defender, while the intention is good, the law must be observed. The Urban Development Corporation, UDC, will this morning sign a multi-million dollar agreement for the sale of the Oceana Hotel in downtown Kingston. The building housed the Health Ministry. The UDC has not disclosed the value of the deal. However, it has disclosed that the property is being sold to a consortium with noted Canadian developers Downing Street, Partners Realty, and Jamaica Property Company Limited. The UDC says it has negotiated the sale of the Oceana Complex as part of its continuing redevelopment thrust in downtown Kingston. For Israelis have been killed and 8 injured as 2 men armed with a pistol and meat cleavers attacked a West Jerusalem synagogue. The attackers, who were Palestinians from East Jerusalem, were shot dead. There have been several deadly attacks and clashes recently in Jerusalem, which has also seen heightened tension over a disputed holy site. Israel has vowed to respond with a heavy hand to the attack. And those are the stories making the latest headlines. News next at 11 o'clock. Stay tuned. Straight Up with Jerry Small continues. I'm Kayla Wright.
Welcome back to Straight Up into the second hour of the program. But I didn't want to set the pace with some text message, but I just remember that the St. Hughes girls, Pass girls. God, I'm an old girl. The St. Hughes Pass Girls Association having a banquet. Is when? I think it's the 28th or 29th of the month. 28th or 29th of the month. And them, yes, they're having a banquet. And guess what? They are allowing males to come to the banquet. You know that St. Hughes is a sister school of Kingston College. And the St. Hughes Pass Girls Association having them annual banquet, and them allowing males to come there, and them allowing males to buy the ticket them to, and buy ticket for the female and come there too. We should have somebody from the St. Hughes Old Girls, Past Girls Association, you know, to help them, tell them about, tell about their banquet that coming up next week, where males and females are allowed. Males are welcome, and the St. Hughes Pass Girls Association is not that them desire male sex, but them desire the company, the pleasure, them desire the pleasure of your company, whether you are male or female. At them, at their Pass Girls Banquet, I think is next week. Should really get in contact with somebody from there and tell you. Alright, like how I make that point there, let me not hold up the call. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Good morning, Mr. Small.
What go on, sir? Right, did I forget to hear that?
Respect, Mr. Small. Mr. Small, yes, slavery.
Sir. Yes, sir.
They did a survey the other day and said that 35 million people in the world is still in slavery.
Why? I hear that something like 16 million people in India alone are enslaved.
Yeah, and China is second.
Yes. And
most 4 slaves live in Asia.
Yes, and 4,000 slaves in Jamaica. No.
Yeah, 4,000. But ironically, Mr. Small, they say most of the slaves in Jamaica are in sex trade, commercial sex.
Yeah.
Sex exploitation is a form of slavery.
Yeah, and I have them captive too, yeah.
Yeah, because when a man now say, you take up a girl and she not working or anything like that, and him buying into her, buying sex from her,
He's
a slave, isn't he?
Yeah, but if him buying from her, if he is buying from her, slavery don't involve paying people for work, it is kidnapping.
Yes.
It's kidnapping. I don't know what to call it, slavery, if him is paying her. But if she is restricted, that is, to me, is kidnapping.
Yes.
Kidnapping is just as serious as murder and slavery.
Why it's sad doing Jamaica to find so many slaves, and that is just what they know about.
That's just what they know about.
Yeah, because they said that it increased by 20% over last year because they are using more sophisticated ways of capturing the data.
Yes.
So I would implore every Jamaican now, especially the black males who look like me, to check their slavery status, you know.
Oh.
Because I heard Mr. Patterson a couple months ago, when he was speaking about some people chopping up somebody's melon plantation in the country and raiding overturned chucks.
Yeah.
Careful how we put ourselves back into slavery.
Yes.
Mr. Small, it's serious.
Yes. But just before you go, have you ever passed by the cultural site there in a New Kingston Shoemaker Gully? It's a cultural attraction, you know.
Yes, Mr. Small, I tell you, the other night I went to a play up at a famous
venue,
theater house up that side.
Yeah.
And when I came out the theater house about 11:30 p.m.
Yeah.
I see more male prostitute than female prostitute in New Kingston.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine tell me, don't let it happen again.
Yeah, a friend of yours, a friend of yours tell you don't make what happen again.
Don't go back in that area at 11:30 any night.
Yes, sir, because...
I may be branded as one of them.
Yes, and they will say that your back is broad.
Yes.
Not good.
I see males in dressed in female clothes.
Yeah.
And have a spiky boot with handbag.
And making money.
A lot, Mr. Small and Kingston just about.
Making money out of the boils of the working class.
Yes, and they have a captive market.
Yeah.
It's sad, Mr.
Small. It's a garrison.
Yeah, it's a garrison.
Well, thank you very much, dear, sir.
All the best to your work is burning in the field.
I tell you, yes, sir. We have some text messages here. Jerry, them resigned from the NHT board because one was forced. And the lady threw it look bad. Them don't mean it. If they did, they would have left the first time them knew about it. Now, I agree that if they did mean it from the bottom of them heart, them would leave early because other members of the board left because of the improper way that the whole thing was being run, the board and the NHT and the thing was being run. Other members left before. But I have to give credit to Miss the lady there. What's her name again? Miss Helene Davis. Because she said that she consulted with her family and her family advised her that the best thing to do is to separate yourself out of this mess. And if you are that human that you can consult with your family, and if your family is that wise that your family can strengthen you and say leave the prestige alone and leave it because it is not good and encourage you to leave, I have to commend that and commend our family. And not only that, she said that the whole board should resign. Not only she resigned, she recommended that the whole board resign. So I have to give her credit for that, even though she never leave immediately at the beginning. Also, Cavan Gale, as you are intimating, left because he was forced. But he has spoken out some things, and it is obvious that when they were there, even though they were absent from some meetings, when they were there, they were not satisfied with how the board was being bullied by somebody who have brought out a retirement specifically to carry out these raids here. These raids. Next one, Robin, have you heard that China will soon be purchasing outer many and Caymanas back? Well, if they purchase the whole Jamaica, everything included, the population have to go negotiate to get themselves out of the purchase. That's what the population have to go do. Next one, Big Tune, Jerry. I think you're talking about Mighty Redeemer by Justin Ives. Well, thank you very much. Next one, Jerry, PNP can't run things. Them run down things. Well, who you recommend? You should put that in your text. Who you recommend for run things? Next one. With respect to outer many, the horse reach winning post, money make, party keep, and everyone eat a food. But someone food gets slapped away. An alarm when compensatory promises were not kept. Yes, it seemed like things get to a nice hunting, but some little carry don't go on. Next one. Out of many government, PNP scandal, NHT money every time. Next one. Jerry, I think that collectively black people are a failed race, so we have to take individual responsibility for our own success and happiness. Now, if we are a failed race, we must pick up ourselves, get up off of the ground, and start all over again. And it's not everyone in the race going to be in the team. Remember, team is not the whole school. Team represents school, but team is not the whole school. So the team of people who are going to pick up themselves is not everybody. Don't wait for everybody, you know. Don't wait for everybody. Not everybody. But I encourage you. Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Yes, Jerry, where man I say?
You know there, man?
Yes, sir. The last caller on this. How much slavery is in China? Yes, I have the report.
I think it's something like 16, thousand, no, more than that, man. 16 million. Is what? How much was it? How much was it? I think it's 16 million, you know. I think them says...
But about the people where they work, where they live, people that the authority doesn't conform with the ILO standards.
Yes.
So they are more small. Some people are, anyway, yes.
Yeah.
China. Yes, Mr. Small, you were talking about him. Oh.
About who?
Oh, one of your colleagues was talking about the shoemaker's gully in New Kingston.
Yes, sir. Have you passed and seen the attraction there?
No, with the help of Professor Carlin Cooper, we're going to put those people back in the closet from when they came, you know, with the greatest respect to them.
How with the help of Carlin Cooper?
Yeah?
How with the help of Carlin Cooper? Because eh? What's that?
She knows her own things, you know. She has
a sense of... I think because the shoemaker old boy association only allow... It's not males they allow, you know. You have to be qualified and...
She said in the same article that her farmers were going to invite some men there at their anniversary or something like that.
Yeah.
It's serious, you know. It's right, some serious thing in the green. I have to write that in fatwa. One time she write about Caribbean men and saltfish. You didn't have it all the time.
What about Caribbean men and saltfish?
She said some Caribbean men.
Yeah.
That's one of the sentences, not a thing, you know.
Yeah.
Some Caribbean men love to eat a certain type of saltfish in private.
Yes.
And when they come in a public, then deny that they have eaten such a saltfish.
So how she get to know about it?
You would have asked her, you know, I think you have asked her.
No. I couldn't bring up that
well,
to
I'm
her.
I'm not going to speculate on why she know about it.
Sir. No, I say how? Oh.
Can we move on, Mr. Small?
Yes. So they don't like fresh fish.
So far,
he's in our... No, I'm easy and cool.
Mr. Cabin Gale, sir.
Yeah.
When I would sympathize with Mrs. Helen Davis White,
yeah.
Reason for withdrawing from the board.
Yes.
Because I sympathize with Mr. Gale, you know.
Because,
you know, say, Mr. Andrew Holness has the sword of the mackerel over his head.
You mean him, Baba? You mean Holness? Holness have an unsigned letter.
Yes, sir.
No, not unsigned. Undated.
In resignation letter, so me couldn't sympathize with him thing there.
But like how the Civil Servant Association man there.
Me not finished. I Kevin Gale yet, you know. And skin,
all right, done him. All right, done him.
As a skillful negotiator like that gentleman, I come say, boy, I certainly, when he never in a certain meeting, certain thing one, you might never put this before now.
Yeah.
But me not sympathize with his excuse because in me younger resigned because I know that if he never resigned, probably Mr. Wooden would have sent that letter and to the Governor General.
Yeah.
So him out of her book, you know, but I could big up Mr. Helen Davis White.
Big up Mr. Helen Davis White?
Yes, sir. So as you were talking about Mr. Grant now.
Which Grant? No, but you want to prolong the thing and then now any time yeah, gone.
But it was six somebody on the board, a 16 member board.
Yeah, no, 15 and 6. 6 resign.
I thought it was 16 and 6 resign.
No, 15.
I said that 6 one.
15, hear me now, I have to go to another call. 15 members and 6 resign.
Yes, but I think it was 16. So
I know that you did think. I know that you did think that, but Carlin Cooper did think, Salfish did think too. Not Carlin Cooper, you know. Thank you very much. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Yeah, Helen Davis.
No, you see. No, there must be somewhere that is sterile. And this program is going to be sterile. You go up on the other program them, and you write your letter. Write a letter. And you know all of the procedure. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir, Mr. Coombs.
Yeah, morning.
What go on?
Yeah, why are you using dark can't climb tree?
The reason dog can't climb tree?
Yeah.
Well, I know some dog who can climb tree, no?
All right, well, them don't know, but me know me, the male can climb tree, but you hear me now?
Yeah.
You're the old same saying.
Yeah.
Dog and pussy come from God, no, I'm a poor cousin.
Yes.
All right, so pussy and dog all the trick them.
Yeah.
So when dog believe he get all the trick them, you run him down to kill him.
Yes.
He jump up on tree and you look down for him, so what a man like you, it better is that good thing to me, I learn everything.
Yes.
And he talk back and say, what a man be swear.
Yeah.
In the pine tree, you can't catch him, you can't go up there.
Yeah.
That's why, you see?
Yes, sir.
It happened all right now, not different from.
Yeah.
Most people go trade and get certain education, certain things.
Yeah.
Get top class, not learn this tomorrow class. Even my cousin got trade as carpenter. When he went out, the man didn't let his work one thing, because from Gavlin to Panzo.
Yes.
When he was cutting, he go by lunch.
Yes.
Because in England right now, big carpenter, but he resigned on your own.
Yeah.
94, 95, somewhere there.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yeah, man.
By the way, you know, Ita Boreal.
My cousin lives there right now. You know, they call you IB.
IB. I know this is your mistake and I call Gibraltar.
Hello. Just give me a break. Let me name it out. You have Gibraltar, you see?
Yes, sir.
Going to leave Netobia going up.
Yeah.
You have Netobia.
Yeah.
No, sorry. You have Gibraltar. I join you in the grazing and I go in the four judge.
Yeah.
You cut cross the hill now. I cut up on the main. You have Ita Boreal.
Yeah.
Then you go pick him out, point the turn, go ahead and feed that four short.
Yeah.
And when you go pick him out, pick him out, then you have one, I don't remember his name.
All right.
But it was owned by Grazine factory.
Yeah.
But it was...
That time Pringle.
Sir?
That time Pringle, wasn't it?
No. After Pringle come out of business, we call them Gibraltar Estate.
Yeah.
Buy it out all of them. So, you have Gibraltar, you know, you have Grazine 1, Grazine 2, Grazine 3. At the present moment, talking to you now, right?
Yes, sir.
That's your name. You name Gibraltar and transfer again.
Yes.
You have Grazine 1, Grazine 2, Grazine
3. All right, and next time again, may you talk.
Okay, why not?
Well, you see me know a little bit of parish, I do.
Yes, man. Anything about send me, you ask me about my boat.
All right, thank you very much. Good morning, welcome, Straight Up, hello. Welcome to Straight Up, hello. Are you there? Go ahead, please.
Morning, Mr. Small.
Welcome, sir. How are you doing?
All is well, sir. I hear Jamaican keep lamenting, Chief, that here in Jamaica there's no opportunity and no way out.
Yeah.
For many of us, the poorer class of persons.
Yeah.
But what I as an individual have done, I've done extensive reading and understanding.
Yeah.
Before His Majesty ascended the throne of Emperor. He had three different tribes in Ethiopia to contend with, to get his message across to them and to make sure that they follow procedure as to what he stated.
Yeah.
So is it this country that is called Jamaica, why is it that we can't adopt certain of his principles of understanding how to run a party, even the politicians here?
I understand whose principle to run a party.
Utilize the principle of His Majesty.
Yes, but His Majesty never run a party still.
No, it wasn't a party really, sir.
Yeah. But him still show off the institution. Because one of the institutions that he established give you a good idea how a party could be run. That institution named the Ethiopian World Federation.
Yes, sir.
And him give it a constitution and him name out. Him and the other people found it, then name out the list of officers that need to be responsible for it and how long they must serve, and they must not serve forever, they mustn't serve for life, they must move on. You understand?
Yes, sir. So, Mr. Small, what I'm saying then, here in Jamaica, why can't we just fundamentally have the JPS then, cut electricity and manufacturing company, have the country work on a shift system? Whereas a man work 8 hours a day, a man work 8 hours a night, you give him a concessionary at the supermarket, they can get flour and rice cheaper. But the thing is just to have the nation at work, sir. That is what I'm really emphasizing on today.
Yes.
Why can't we implement ways of just putting the nation to work?
Yeah, there's nothing to stop a serious set of people in Jamaica from start into those things. Nothing to stop. And I wish you success in your study, because it's obvious that you're studying.
Yes,
and that you're learning and that you're adjusting your approach. It is obvious. Thank you very much. Yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello?
Hello?
Welcome, sir.
Hello, Jerry?
Yes, sir. Welcome.
How are you, Jerry, man? It's Blue Mountain Man talking to you, man.
Oh, yes, sir, man.
Me Diana, man. You know, see me have a problem, man. I hear something this morning, Jerry, and boy, I tell you, boy, I said, really, Jamaica is not a paradise, the truth.
No.
I have a problem here, man. I have a pinch nerve problem here. I went to the doctor and they gave me a letter to take to the public hospital.
Yeah.
And when I went down there and go for the X-ray department, those of them tell me so the X-ray not working.
Yeah, that is that University West Hospital or?
No, that public Kingston public hospital.
Public, yeah.
I'm saying that a poor man of people down there crying a jury for help and pain and then suffer when they have to go on the X-ray to see doctor. Because without the X-ray, the doctor can't give them no form of medication and not in a jury. And you tell me say that this country, you know, in a hospital like that, then the X-ray machine now work. Jerry, what's the intern for is the money that is not the thing? We don't understand the system.
Why this complaint been going on so long, man?
Mr. Jerry, terrible man, Mr. Jerry, write me a piece on pain, Mr. Jerry, I'm going to come back and sit down under the pain because they cannot help me. I mean, you can't afford to pay for X-ray with value over $6,000-$8,000 because it's a poor you trying. And where we're supposed to go as poor people get to help, that's where they want to tell us about X-ray machine, bro. And that's all I can tell you now. And you must go out and do it and come back to them. Where you find the money to do it at road, Jerry? So you can't tell what I'm going in this country. Jesus Christ, boy.
Right,
you know what I mean? So I said, I have to call the bridge and see what can be done because there needs some shaking up from the air. You know what I mean? Because the same people when my cars will come vote for them when they want to win the election, yeah. And the same people are suffering in them hands. So we want to know how it all goes.
And when, when Roger Clark, nerve pinch, them organize and can't send them go for it.
You understand me? You see it? And the same problem I have right now, you know? The same problem I see it? Me can't get no help. And him let go of foreign and he's still dead. He's still dead, you know? Go America and send a bag of money and still dead up there, you know? You understand? But if you stay at Jamaica, you're dead at Jamaica and they don't understand what is the position and what is the problem here. This country now has serious crisis, you know, Jerry? This country now has serious, and I want these Jamaican people to realize and understand. And boy, cut the election thing and stop voting people like them are idiots and because it's not going to help with.
Yeah.
It's going to help with down.
Yeah, but the boycott alone by itself, that is not going what not you have,
me agree, you
have to think out some more
revolution
things.
Going then.
Yes, we have to think out some more things. Effect.
Yeah, man, so a revolution, I don't think it's a revolution. I don't know African only.
But don't get too emotional. What you must do, you see? What I'm asking you to do before you call back this program.
Yes.
Go away and study revolution and find out what revolution really is, and that time you won't get so emotional about it. Yes, sir. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Good morning, Jerry. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. How are you doing?
Excellent. Jerry, I had the opportunity to hear pieces of what you were saying this morning about the overseas workplace program, and I just had to comment.
Yeah.
My name is Devon. I'm calling from the Jamaican Network of Seropositives.
What?
The Jamaican Network of Seropositives.
What is seropositive?
Yeah, we've been around since, 1996, really it's a network that has been advocating for all these years for persons living with HIV.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, for all these years, Jerry, yeah. And so it really hurt, I wouldn't say hurt my heart, but it shocked me, and it concerned me when I hear things like, that would suggest that persons living with HIV are vectors or carriers of diseases or somehow a danger to the society.
Yeah. Who lately have heard state that?
You, Jerry. Jerry, you just tell the man when he called about it, when he was advocating for a more compassionate policy.
Yeah.
You said, well, you're not sure about it because the other country, you're going to put a strain on their economy. And also you're going to put a risk to their security.
Hello, listen here. I didn't say I'm not sure because I said I have not thought about it enough and I have not made up my mind about it.
But Jerry, when HIV was introduced to the world, people have been dying and advocating and living.
I know, but I'm telling the truth. Yes, but I'm telling.
Persons who are positive are getting married to negative persons.
Yes, but listen here now.
Positive persons are having negative babies.
But listen here now.
So to suggest that a positive person in Jamaica does not have the right to opportunity that is afforded to every other Jamaican is discrimination.
Well, listen here now.
Discrimination that is not justified by...
Could you indicate to me when you're going to... Alright. Could you...
even be considered, Jerry. That's
okay, could you indicate to me when you're going to allow me to say something?
Good. Jerry, it's my first opportunity. I feel good about being on your show. You have a very good show.
Alright. Let's go for a break and come back. Yeah. Welcome back to Straight Up. Are you there, sir? Are you there? Good morning and welcome back to Straight Up. Are you there? Well, I was hoping that I would hold on. I told him I was going for a break. Well, I was hold on that I could have some more, that start some reason in because I wasn't allowing me at first. Well, hear this now. I tell the honest truth that I have not had a chance to make up my mind, even temporarily, about what is my attitude towards discriminating against overseas employment, against people with HIV in respect of our overseas employment program. And what I wanted to ask him is this, if any employment program, whether overseas employment program or local, if one of the requirements that the employer puts out for their prospective employees is the person must be in good health. Does somebody say anything wrong with an employer saying the person must be in good health and in good standing in their community? They stand in the community and have nothing to do with them, I'm HIV positive. But suppose an employer say, we want some people to work with us as security guards. They must have a good school record and they must be in good standing in their community. People in the community must not have them off like, say, boy, that's a person that you don't want to see hanging around near to your yard. Is anything wrong with such requirements? Anyway, never get to reason. Next call. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello? Good morning. Welcome.
Hello?
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello?
Hello? Hello? May I answer?
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello? That call there now, too much commotion. I can't hear them. Can't hear them. I'm not going to be able to talk to them over the commotion. It was like the call from, good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Good morning, Mr. Small.
Welcome, sir.
Yes, good morning. It's Keith Gardner.
Hi, how are you doing, sir?
Yes, not too bad. Just a word about Kingston College.
Yes, sir.
Jerry.
Yes, sir.
You probably know that I attended Kingston College between 1965 and 1971.
Yes, I remember.
Yes, and those are glorious years. I attended school with some very great men.
Yes, sir.
I had great then and some achieved greatness. Hugh Crosskill was my best friend, my classmate.
Yes.
And,
Hugh transferred there too?
His first year, when he came, when
oh,
came,
yes,
came
oh, yes.
From England.
Oh, yes, yes.
Himself and Darrell.
Yes, Darrell.
He became head boss.
Yes, sir. Yes, true.
And, great academics like Professor Wilkes, Professor S. Coffrey,
yeah.
And others.
Yeah,
Others achieved greatness like Barraji and so on.
Yes, sir.
You know, our headmaster at the time, Douglas Forrest,
yeah.
Inculcated in us certain values. Of course, during the time, Bishop Gibson had retired, but he came on Wednesday and had double chapel with us.
Yeah.
And one of the things Doug inculcated in us was never to wash our dirty linen in public.
Right.
Right? But having said that, though, there are persons who have a voice. Because I remember while I was in school, I didn't see very many fathers taking their sons to school. It was yeah. The mothers,
yeah.
Bigger sisters, and so on. You probably know that Kingsley Cooper was head boy for Casey at some time.
Yeah, that's Carlin's brother.
Precisely. So Professor Cooper has a voice,
yes.
You know. I was invited to go to the graduation, and I haven't been to many, but I was committed to go to this one. And then I heard all of this furor about women not being allowed. I am not homophobic by virtue of my socialization.
Yeah.
I might have grown up in a ghetto that was averse to that sort of thing, but coming up, in school and then becoming a lawyer, you know, to respect other persons' belief and
yeah,
so on.
Yeah.
But I was a bit turned off, though, by the fact that the assertion that women were not to be invited because they have played such an immense role in the development of the school that I find it a little bit strange and I was concerned. Also found it, although I'm the father of 17 children, and so on. I really was minded to carry one of my younger daughters this year.
Yes.
My son is a Woolmerian, and I don't think that you'd have wanted to go.
Yeah.
So I was a bit disappointed, you know, that the first time that I decided to carry somebody that it was not allowed. And I'm getting into any dispute with my 40th friend.
Yeah.
You know, because persons would, those of us who went to school would know that I was a very popular KSE boy, you know.
Yes, yes.
From first form, I got the name Tenge, which was came out of an imperfect conjugation of the word tener. Should I say Tenge, TNS, TNS, Tenge, TNS, TNN?
Yes.
I said Tenge, Tengo, and you know, that sort of nonsense. So the very first week, that name Tenge stuck with me.
Yeah.
I was in the Army Cadets and the band, and then for a time in the Kingston College Chapel Choir. So I was very, very active, you know, and
yeah.
I love my school. But I'm a bit concerned about the development, you know, and I'm wondering whether the powers that be within the KC Old Boys Association could reconsider because, you know, we really want to honor women.
Yeah.
And, you know,
Well,
that's my take, you know, Jerry.
Well, as I said, I believe that it is for the KC fraternity to discuss these things, and like, as you have expressed yourself, and gradually, either gradually or suddenly, you overwhelm their opinion. When I say, well, not by force, no, by force of argument, especially as an advocate, a lawyer, as a reasonable person, overwhelm them opinion and say, boy, yes, it's time. But anyway, people from outside shouldn't dictate, but it should be left to you, gentlemen.
Jerry, I don't see I don't see anything really fundamental wrong with a group of guys coming together and having a drink and having a chat.
Yeah.
But taking into consideration where we are in 2014,
yeah,
I don't think that we should arbitrarily exclude the woman from.
No, but I'm saying no. Isn't it inside the association that this convincing should take place?
Precisely. I think that there should be greater dialogue.
And I believe like,
you know,
I believe like that people like yourself would be able to sway them. I think they will be stubborn to get take direction from people.
However, the president now is a great man, and I mean, when I went out to vote, I couldn't even get in. I couldn't enter North Street.
Yeah.
Because he had overwhelming support. So, you know,
yeah,
I'd like to continue to support him, but
yeah,
let us start the dialogue.
One more thing.
Exclusionary, you know.
One more thing. The great dogs, as you mentioned, and Bishop Gibson, who would have overseen the formation of the World Students Association from the early 30s. They approved and allowed from those times that this function would be all male.
Yes.
So you acknowledge that these traditions take some time.
Precisely.
To,
I don't know. They were men of vision, but I don't know whether at that time they could look to where a woman are.
Yeah.
And I think at this stage, Dogs would not be, if I'm even bold enough to say, I don't think Dogs or even Bishop Gibson would be averse to having, you know.
And my own experience is that the year my son spent there, I was so grateful for people like Miss Douglas, who was a deputy and sometime acting principal. I was so grateful for persons like herself and some of the other females who are members of staff. But I think it's for you, gentlemen, to settle on the side. But thank you very much for your call.
Okay, Jerry, thank you for listening.
Anytime. Thank you very much. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Morning.
Welcome.
Well,
good morning.
Good morning, sir. I'm a student from Career Academics.
Career Academics. Where?
Career,
yes, ma'am. Where?
Academic, yes. Professional Studies for Nursing.
Where is this?
This is in Mandeville, run by Campbell Wholesale Plaza.
Okay, go ahead, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I'm having a major problem at the school.
Yeah.
We were told we have signed a contract over here.
Yeah, what?
On the farm, we were told that we can wear plain, just modest, if our uniform is not clean and so forth.
Hold on. You're told that you can wear plain dress and plain clothes.
In case anything should happen to our uniform.
Okay. You can't.
And now, as our final day at exam, and the principal push us out the school and say we can't sit the exam on our final day.
Hello, is there a fee for the exams, ma'am?
Oh, we pay $7,500 per term.
No. Listen to me. Hello. Listen to me. I'm asking you, different from school fees, is there a fee for the exam?
No, it's included.
Okay, so yes, the exam fee is included, okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go for a break and come back, please.
Okay.
Welcome back to Straight Up, yes. We heard you there, ma'am? Hello, are you there? Hello, are you there? We don't have that caller. What happened to the call? I heard, good morning, welcome. Are you there?
I'm here, Jerry.
Oh, there was a caller there, but it sounded like a different person who started to talk to me about Career Academics. Next call. Good morning. Yes, sir. Welcome.
Morning, Jerry.
Welcome, sir.
Smarty Pickney here.
Okay.
I I'm calling in response to a call you got a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
A gentleman had called to say that he noticed that black people only sing and dance and act. I don't know if you remember that call.
I have a vague recollection. It's not as precise as what you say.
Yeah, but he was saying that those are the only things that black people does.
Yes.
I think it is our responsibility as students, as adults, to educate ourselves about the world in general, our race, our nationality, and so on.
Yeah.
I would just like to point out a few things that African people are responsible for.
Yeah, achievements.
As you know, the first university in Timbuktu.
Yeah.
It is African people who the refrigerator was invented by Jacob Perkins, a black person. They listen to the light bulb, traffic signal, heart pacemaker, IBM computers, electric microphone, cell phone, shoemaking machine by John Matsenija. That increased the productivity of making shoes by over 900%. There is also Imhotep that I think we all know of. We gave the world much. And it's a long list. I will not go any further because of the time constraint. But we have been doing things. Some of us just refuse to educate ourselves about us.
Yeah, that is true. That is true. Mm.
Okay.
That is true. Well, it's welcome for you to come and remind us about some of the individual accomplishments of African-blooded people. And that is just the tip of the iceberg. Well, thank you very much. Here, sir.
Okay, Jim.
Welcome, sir. Thank you very much. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello. Good morning and welcome back to Straight Up. Hello. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello. Well, we have some confusion going on there. It's not going to work. Next call. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello? Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Quiet.
Yes, Mr. Small.
Yes, Mr. Brown. Wagwan.
Greetings to Mr. Small and Mrs. Small, eh?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Small. My take with the... With the NHT thing, you see?
Yes, sir.
As can to what he said, the man, he did a wrong thing to purchase the property.
Which man that?
Easton Douglas.
Oh, but he was him by himself, but he probably steered it.
Yes, him did. But the thing about it, and him not thief the money, you see me?
Don't thief which money?
The money we him use buy the property.
Yeah.
And not thief him piece.
No, but that is worse.
Yeah, but
if he stole the money and bought it, that would be his business. But yeah, it's our money.
Say no.
Yeah.
This big halabaloo with jail thief.
Yeah.
And stick out pan it and go and question and more question and more question. You know what I see?
Yeah.
I see a political thing, you know.
Yeah.
And then get a little thing for whole arm pan.
Yeah.
But I am saying to somebody what that my name was that the more people, lesser people are on the NHT more than the people out the door there.
Yeah.
But that street.
Yes.
You understand? Because millions of people now work and it's thousands with the NHT and them are doing things.
Yeah.
So, going around and beating this dead dog.
Yeah.
Not going to bring him back to life because the money spent on the property and the property is dear.
Yes.
Because I hear Lambert Brown say, if anything, the property can sell back and make back more than with them PFP.
And that's unreasonable?
Yeah.
How much it can sell back for?
I don't know.
You don't have no idea?
I don't have no idea.
They always say it's unreasonable.
No, the saying of Lambert Brown sound reasonable.
Yeah, but him tell you how much it can sell back for?
Him say you can get, you may can get a 40 million.
40?
Yes.
40 out of how much?
Remember 108.
No, I think him was saying that you can get 40 more than what them pay for it.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
But the mouth make to talk and express.
Yeah, I agree.
But mouth is not market.
I know that. But here what I discover now. All JLP in the wilderness and them well one get the hang of government.
Ah, true, man.
So them whole and pan that one little thing now.
Which little thing?
The NHT thing.
Then wait, what, $200 million?
I agree, say, something wrong. Mm. But if the man did thief the money, you could have said, boy, I will live. But a value there, you know?
Value? How much value?
The 180 million.
How much you call on?
Well, that is cause of concern because you...
No, don't go around. Just tell me the number you call on.
I think it's 10, you know.
No, 9. So 9 into 180 is how much?
Well, my math, yes.
No, 9 into 180 is 20. That means each acre of that land costs $20 million.
Yeah.
What you can do with land will cost $20 million acre?
I don't think you can do much.
Then how you say it's not a big thing?
No, what I'm saying, you know, I know, sir, him should have really...
All right, listen here now. We have to go do it. We have to talk more about it.
No,
when we have...
me finish.
No. If you finish, the other callers' money going to run out.
You see, them can always fight, but them not. I win the next election.
Yes, oh, good, yes, okay. All right. Good, next call. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Welcome, sir.
Come on, the point with the farmer thing, yes. The HRT test.
Yeah.
I was thinking along the lines where probably because of farming, the person I'm going to deal with.
Yeah, farming, yeah.
Farming.
Yeah.
And a food thing.
Yeah.
I know that the HRT can make because if you get a cut or anything on a food, you're going to deal with. I don't think that in Jamaica, if you're going to work in a restaurant, you cannot have that. You cannot have HIV or AIDS.
I kind of doubt it, but the farming, what they might do is not cooking food.
No, but a food you're hungry the same way.
Then the HIV can spread to the food that they might plant?
No, what are not planting, not planting, they might reap it.
Alright, the HIV can spread to the food that they might reap?
No.
What it, then how the HIV can affect the food?
No, I'm just thinking that I was saying probably that's what they're saying.
Oh.
You know, probably you're doing farming and you can get a cost.
Yes, I understand.
And you go up on the food, you know?
Chances, yeah,
you know them way there?
I think they're more concerned about after you're done with the farm work at daytime.
What you go do?
And you go out at night time, you might meet a nice lady, citizen over there, especially if it's a nice white lady.
And you
go cut, you don't give her nothing, but you cut her by mistake. And then now you go fall on power, all kind of thing. Maybe. And then feel like, say, when we are walking, you know, say, most of us walk barefoot.
Yeah.
And true, we are walk barefoot now, and no have no water boot, no nothing. And we go fall on power, our foot go muddy or up all them kind of thing.
Understand,
but up to now, I don't make up my mind whether I really agree with it or not. I need some time to process it.
Okay, well, that's the one I'm applying them.
Yes, sir. Quickly.
Not applying. People that talk about gay rights and lesbian rights.
Yeah.
People in the world need to realize it.
straight man and straight woman have rights too.
Yes, yes.
And we need to have our opinion, just like how them say that them want to do for them thing.
Yeah.
And them want, in fact, they want to feed them children.
Yeah.
If them can't get any.
Yeah.
We need to say to our rights to say, we not in that neither.
Yes.
Just like how them want to have for them rights to say, we in that with them.
Yes, yes.
They in that with them.
Yeah, well, I do. I appreciate the call, especially they sound like a young person, but I kind of out of time. Call me again soon. I'm going to talk some more, but glad to get a call from a young person.
All right, I'm going to big up my mother and my stepfather country.
Yo, what's them name?
Mr. and Mrs. Linton, yeah?
Mr. and
Mrs. Linton.
Which part of them, the St. Ann?
Westmoreland.
Westmoreland. Mr. and Mrs. Linton. Landilo. Mr. and Mrs. Linton and Landilo.
Yeah, man.
All right, thank you very much. Yeah, I was going to say hello to the next person. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello. Morning and
Jerry,
welcome.
Morning.
Yes, welcome, sir.
Yeah, man. Mr. Brown Junk.
Which one are you, Brown?
The one I called before I called it.
Oh, Mr. Brown, oh yes, yes, yes. If I'm drunk, why you say I'm drunk?
You take a bar my come from.
Why you say so? Why you say so?
Anyway, what may I say? Me da listen, Andrew over there. And me take say the man he don't come with something good, you know what I say?
Who is Andrew?
Wellness.
Oh.
Because right now, you know, say dog eat with supper in Jamaica, you know, because a pure fool in this country and high politics, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, Jamaican people have to decide their mind now because the politicians are not going to help them.
Oh.
Because me take say the man has talked about the same old and those thing there. Me take say the man, I say, all right, you know, you see me win now.
Yeah.
People have to get a call.
Yes.
Well, him not in that, him just in a pure like, foolishness. Me not know if you don't listen still.
Yeah, me listen to somebody. But listen here now, we're out of time completely.
Yeah.
See if you can call back again before the program done.
Yeah, man, easy.
Straight up. Yes. Welcome back to Straight Up. I'll read some text messages before we rejoin the phone calls. First one. Best person to contact you on the St. Hugh's banquet is Carolyn Cooper as an old girl. Carolyn Cooper is an old girl, you know. She's a golden girl. Next one. Jerry, the Minister of Labor needs to check the Chinese workers' medicals because some of them work in Africa. Yeah. Next one. Jerry, did your friend Ken Baugh of the JLP do a good job as Minister of Health? I never said him, you know. But who tell us I'm my friend? Him saved my old man life one time, I'll say, you know. Yeah, when I was a surgeon. In the 70s at the Cornwall Regional Hospital, Ken Baugh. See, I'm old man life one time, but I never tell you, say, I'm a friend. Well, I'm grateful to him still. But I never say, so them do a good job as Minister Health. Next one. Good morning, Jerry. Good morning, Jerry, and your very competent staff. Mr. Coombs was trying to remember Epsom in St. Mary, Enfield and Epsom, and in St. Thomas East. Cheers. Thank you very much for the help, dear ma'am. Helping us, along with Mr. Coombs, to sort out some history and some geography of Jamaica, St. Mary especially. Next one, Jerry Small, good day. What do you think about the by-election in Westmoreland? Who is going at it? I never think about it. There's plenty of things I don't think a lot about, you know. I never think about it that much. It seemed like a PNP stronghold. The lady who is a, what she say, she's a banker. Lady says she was a banker. She have a lot of brave talk, and brave talk is good. As I tell you this morning, it is good to make good claims and then try to live up to either good claims that are true or good claims and then try to live up to it. Because if you claim something, you can claim something and then live up to it. You know, it's not a false thing to claim something and then live up to it. Like if you claim, like when you say, I claim success. And I'm working towards success. Yeah, that's positive thinking. You claim it, and then you go at it. That's how Bolt and all those other successful people get successful. And they claim it for themselves, and then they do the work that is necessary to get between point A and point B, which is the start line and the finish line, before anybody claim it, yes? Next one. I, Jerry, AJ Nicholson, and Arnaldo Brown must go because them sit down and make call while Bahamas are send back the picnic that was born there and every nation there. Yeah, they're sending home some Jamaican children that were born in the Bahamas. And I think this, I'm not sure if it's illegal by their laws, it seems so though. Next one, out of many, only two of them resigned. Playing blame game. Who did do what first or who worse? Not putting Jamaica or Jamaicans anywhere. One thing I know, you can learn, regardless of how you might feel, you can learn when things are unraveling and unfolding, you can learn. So even though you might call it blame game, if you want to learn and know what to do better next time, or if you want to learn and understand human behavior and Jamaican behavior and politician behavior or any kind of behavior, you listen when things are unfolding. So it might be simple to say it's blame game. You can learn. And you can tune out if you want to. And pay attention to something else. Prime Minister, pay attention to other things. She's very good at what she pay attention to. And not so good at what she don't pay attention to. That's the same thing with every human being. I don't pay attention to American football. I can't understand it all now. I don't pay attention to it. I pay attention to other things and I understand them more. It's life. Good morning, welcome to Straight Talk. I think we have one more. Jerry, why the people leave the conference of the GLP Sunday? The people leave? I don't know. I don't know. I never watch it. I don't know about it. Why the people leave the conference of the GLP Sunday? I don't understand this. I don't know. People that leave? I mean, when it done, I support them leave. I don't know about it. People that stream out of there and it broke down? I don't know. Yes, do we have anyone on the line here? Yes, we do. Good morning, welcome to Straight Talk.
Morning, Jerry.
What go on, sir?
Yeah. Yesterday.
Yes, sir.
When we did that talk to you about Mugabe and standing up.
Yeah, yeah.
You send me go back in and my head back, you see?
Yeah.
And when I look across Africa.
Yeah.
I can name out four leaders.
Yeah.
We kind of look like them are stand up, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
You have Yahya Jammeh from Gambia.
Yeah.
You have Mugabe.
Yeah.
You have Zuma.
Yeah.
And you have Uhuru Kenyatta.
Oh, yes, yes.
Now you ask me if Mugabe just stand up to the Chinese.
Yeah.
I would say yeah, to some extent, you know.
Yeah.
Because right now, they might try to bend him to get some agreement. And him not bend, you know.
Yeah. What is the agreement? What do they want?
Well, he wants some money from them.
What they want?
Well, as per usual, whole heap of land.
Yeah.
Access to whole heap of things.
So he wants some money, that means I'm willing to sell if them pay the right money.
Well, I don't know, but him not take where them are say. But after a dozen or more trips, not 1 cent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A dozen trips by who?
Mugabe.
To China. Oh. Yeah.
No.
And I'm about 90 now?
Yeah.
What about traveling?
91 this year.
Yeah.
Now, Zuma look like him a follow Mugabe's look. Oh, what? Where me see Mugabe I do now is a Russia me see him start to turn to.
Yeah.
Yeah. And me see Zuma I do the same thing too.
Yeah.
But man like Yahya Jammeh is now on. Uhuru Kenyatta, them man then Uhuru Kenyatta, them kinda have him by a delicate position there, you know.
How? Eh? How come?
So the case where him have the ICC.
The case not finished yet?
No.
Oh, I thought it was finished.
No man. He must go there the other day. Apparently, the witness, some witness are back down, and the witness for the prosecution, it not really look good.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, I don't know, are them four man, them are kind of sick right now.
Yeah.
Most of them are mostly puppet.
Yes, I need to get more up to date with some, but we need to get some contact with various people inside of each one of these countries. Various people from different standpoint. But thank you very much. Yes, sir?
Yeah, give, sir.
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello? Welcome. Are you there? Go ahead, please. Go ahead, please. Good morning. Welcome.
Straight My up. Name is Osumar.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
Not too bad, sir.
Yeah, man.
In relation to the conversation between you and Mr. Brown, sir.
Yes, sir.
With the outer many.
Yeah.
I think you have some corrections to make, you know.
Yeah, help me now.
Yeah, the land. You know, a valuation was done on the property. I heard it on another station.
Yeah.
And it was for $349 million, you know.
A valuation was done on the land alone?
No, not the land alone, the whole property.
Yes, and?
It's for $349 million.
Yes.
So, when you say it's $20 million an acre,
yeah,
it is not fully correct.
It's more.
Less, man.
No, but if it's more money value, then it must be more money per acre.
Alright, let me explain to you. The land itself, is it?
Yeah.
Value $12.8 million.
Value how much?
$12.8 million. The great house. Hello?
Yeah, go on, man.
The great house value over $50 million.
Yeah.
And some other things add up to the $249 million.
No, tell me the other things. Look here.
I don't
remember. Hold on. 12 point something million.
Yes.
Call it 13.
Eh?
Call it 13 million for the land.
I call it 12, maybe 11 point something.
Call no, it, right, call it 13. Call it 13.
Yeah.
And the great house value 50 odd.
Yeah.
Call it 60.
Yeah.
That are 73, the great house and the land value.
Yeah.
And you say some other things bring it up to 300.
300.
And you just brush it off. To some other things. So he's
on them call some gazebo.
What?
The gazebo then.
Yeah, yeah.
And them say the restaurant.
Yes.
Bathroom, the walkway.
Yeah.
Everything them add up in it and it come to 248, the valuation.
Yes. Then if
I don't remember if it's Fletcher or something like that. You can't check it out.
Yes. Then if it come to 300 odd million.
Yeah.
And it's how much acre land?
9 acres.
And if it's 9 acres, you divide 9 into 300, you get how much?
What, mister? You say you're making a mistake. What I'm saying, when they definitely said that, the land itself, them value for 11 million.
We passed this, you know?
Yes, but you go back, you say,
the
land itself.
So the 230 million, we're going to bring it up to 30. Is what value that?
The building and the roads and things like that and cafeteria, bathroom, whatever.
Then all them things not upon the land.
Yeah?
Then those things not on the land.
I know, but the thing you are giving you, I say by acre land value, how much a acre?
Yes.
But you're not being truthful.
And what? I'm not being what?
Truthful.
But you are being truthful though.
Yes.
I know.
No, man, but just check it out for the record. We have to get it right, you know, man.
Yeah, you have to get it right.
Yeah. Who came on a news station.
Yes, yes. Who have to get it right?
You, that you can tell the people.
Yes, but you have it right already, though.
The information I got.
Yes, no, the question is, you have it right, okay?
We won't discuss that. Bye-bye.
What you say, boom, what? What you say, what? Boom, what? I think him say boom, bye-bye. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello? Morning, welcome. Straight Up, hello? In my grind, I ask. I wonder if I want to ask him off a grind. Mr. Robinson, rapper song anything. My grind, I ask there. But you have to be careful while grinding the axe, you know. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Yes, good morning, Jerry.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah, man, I'm Straight Up.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, well, we have two of them, them Shine and Boogie,
yeah,
and Al, Mr. Kazi.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. You see, at the end of the program,
yes, sir.
Jerry.
Yes, sir.
Like, on a Friday.
Yeah.
What me don't want you to do? Me don't want you to make it more nicer, like, some better encouragement. Give some people, give me some encouragement.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, enjoy your weekend and stuff like that. But when you just hang up and just say, boy, all right, that's it, that's straight up.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, adapt me that one, you do.
Yes.
Because I remember, you know, Jerry, you're my role model, you know, and you're my teacher.
Yeah.
And a lot of things me learn from you.
But you...
And
but
me,
you,
me
but...
learn some from even somebody else, call as them, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But me can learn from you, too.
Well,
that's why I tell you this now.
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all right, I'm going to take a note of that. I'm going to try it.
Yeah, man, because you have it in here, Jerry.
Yeah.
Because listen, you have everything in here, you're a selector.
Yeah.
You have everything.
Yeah.
Because you give me some nice tune last week.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, for real, man.
All right, well, thank you very much, here, sir.
Yeah, man, bless up yourself, Jerry.
Thank you very much. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello. Welcome, Straight Up, are you there? Yes.
Hello, good morning.
Welcome, sir.
Good morning, Jerry.
Yes, sir.
Just three quick thoughts. I won't take much of your time.
Yeah.
You can work with your figure with of $20 million, you know.
Yes.
Sanguinity was thought of complicating the thing a little. We can work with the $20 million.
Yes.
It's fair to do that.
I hear him say that. And no, I think that somebody was trying to.
Yeah,
I think somebody was trying to make a calculation that it only work out at $12 million acre instead of 20.
Yeah.
But from him here at 12.
Mm-hmm. But at $20 million acre is like a gold mine or a diamond or maybe an oil well.
Yeah, but him not explaining what make everything else come up to 300 odd.
Yeah, I think he was trying to break down the infrastructure.
But I think him a grind.
Earth and all of that. But
him have an axe. Him have an axe a grind, you know. But you mustn't grind axe against the teeth. You must find a grindstone.
Yeah. Two other things quickly.
Yeah.
Superintendent Gardner.
Yes, sir. No, he's not superintendent. He's a retired assistant commissioner.
Right. Oh, sorry, man. That's a long time ago, superintendent.
Yeah, man.
Quite right, Jerry.
Yeah.
But he made a point, and I'm not sure if I heard him correctly, but I think he said he refrained from voting in the KC election.
No, he said he couldn't get to vote like the crowd was so big.
Oh, because I get the impression that he was saying he didn't vote because the man who was favorite was overwhelmingly so. And like him, never bothered to vote because you couldn't take him out.
So
I was just going to make the point that it's important, even if you're the only man who is going to vote against him, to register that dissent, you know?
Yeah.
It's important. Apparently,
I misunderstood, yes.
Yeah, to make sure, you know, even if you are the only man, as Chronic say, register it.
Yeah.
That I did not want this man. Let it be known I said that.
Yeah.
So, but as I said, super, you know, Mr. Gardner, Trinity, is a man, you know, he's a move on shaker. He's one of the big shots in the country.
Yeah.
So his opinion is really important.
Crack shot, too.
And there might be another person there who have the same opinion who, if he had expressed his, they might have said, boy, you know what, that's what I think too.
Yes, because me must be the only man in Jamaica where Portia Simsimila is not my leader.
You only vocal one.
No, but
a brave one.
No, but I believe she's the leader for all the rest of the people in Jamaica.
I think what happened there, Jerry, is that you have strong family background which enable you to speak freely. A lot of us, you know.
I know so much background, you know.
Can't talk so freely.
I know so much background, you know, backbone. And then now you have to do business with society and now move up in the society.
Yeah. Finally.
Yeah.
The gentleman who said he sold some chicken at $16 a pound, £100 a chicken. When the man cut $2,000 off it, I get the impression he have no intention of paying that $2,000, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
You'd have been better off telling, give me $15 a pound.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, you have some people cruel, you know, rob all the blind.
Yes, man, it's hard for college. Cruel. $2,000 now.
But you know what happened?
We have to buy gas for that.
Yes, but we have to find ways, you see, where we wrench some justice out of the people and we rob all the blind. Wrench it out of them.
Yeah.
May I tell you? I have to go. Thank you very much.
Okay, yeah.
Welcome to Straight Up, hello? Welcome.
Hello.
Good morning. Welcome, sir.
How are you doing today?
Fine, thank you. Wagwan.
Yeah, man, everything is everything. You know, you can't believe the man there a while ago said the reason why you have a little gut and your backbone is because of your family ties.
Yeah.
Eh?
People think, it's easy to think that kind of, you know.
Yeah, but you know, that's one of the biggest problems with Jamaica, though. Most of the people out there are cowards, you know.
Yeah, it's a big...
You can't, you know, see it, but I tell a man.
It's a big problem.
The reason why... So much advantage can take a people.
Yeah.
Because them afraid to defend themselves and to go out there and...
Yeah, them afraid.
Stand up, you know?
Yeah, them afraid.
And show like to them have like a
You know why I use the B word.
Yeah, people are afraid of how much it will cost. Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, the man, but well, you know, yeah, man, for real, anyway. Here, some people articulate some ideas, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I must have like to get some clarification. Well, you understand sports tourism for me.
Sports tourism is a form of tourism where people who are attracted to travel to countries where they can either practice some sports or watch sports are attracted to that country. Like in Switzerland and certain other places, a lot of people go there just to ski.
Right.
Some people go to California mostly for the surfing and them kind of thing and sunbathing. All of those are various aspects. You can go place the World Cup. You can go up a place called the World Cup and keep them stay all 3 months. Various, yeah.
Yeah, I understand what you mean. Most of the people who visit Jamaica come from the United States.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I think so.
How much do you think could I really come out to come watch cricket? The same build a big stadium.
Yeah.
When they have done some cricket thing back in the day.
Yeah.
And it was a big failure.
Yeah, and them did.
Not the idea, but that to me, I don't see where it really are going to be a big success, the sports tourism thing. Because most of the people that come from here, them most interesting are the American football and basketball and all of that.
Yeah, the cricket stadium.
I mean, they can really shine as far as them thing is concerned.
No, the cricket stadium was.
You them shine as with the athletic. You know what I mean?
Yeah. The cricket stadium.
You know, to me, it's like a bankrupt idea, you know? That some people have pushed where they really, I think, have nothing where really practical and where they really work. You know what I mean?
The cricket stadium is very much like the Ottoman thing. Yet I believe that a big stadium in the western part of Jamaica can be a big asset, but it was not like the Ottoman thing, and like as somebody has commented recently, not thought through properly, not planned, nothing like that. The main thing is to take things and get things. I got the cricket stadium there, I think with a whole lot of gift and a whole lot of free thing, and just like the stadium where was built up in Sligo, we look at Katie and I get a free gift from China. Very good for Sligoville to have a stadium, but they waste it. When people get good thing and don't know, they value it and just want things, them waste it. Just want things. I really have to go.
I called a while ago and I send the purchase at that place.
No, I can't go no further with that now. I feel no way. The time run out and we have a whole heap of call, but you start out a very good discussion. Thank you, brother. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello.
Good morning, Mr. Small. How
Yes, ma'am, how are you doing, ma'am?
Mr. Small.
Yes, ma'am.
May I go ask you a few little questions?
Yeah, ma'am.
1 acre of land, how many townhouse can you get off right?
A lot of townhouse, you can get a lot of townhouse. I can't tell you precisely, but you can get quite a few townhouse over 1 acre land. You probably can get about 20, I don't know.
All right. And check about 1 acre of land, how many studio can you get off right?
Studio.
Right. You know what I find very contrary?
Yes, ma'am.
The government hardly can balance. So the rich people them buy the land.
Yeah.
When them buy the land and they make the house, then turn it over back to the NHC. So be the case the government don't lose, and so be the case the rich people get something quite sufficient.
Well, here what's happening in Jamaica? The black rich people, you see, are learning all of the tricks of the white rich people and the yellow rich people and the brown rich people. So the black rich people are demanding all of the same lies where them see the white rich people and all the other rich people get over here, the black rich people.
I feel, say, the land that them buy, I feel, say, that land is going to turn into a townhouse or a apartment.
Yes.
It's not what they say to do with it.
Yes, I agree. I agree that it's not an investment for the poor people. It is an investment in a rich people for wealthy people.
Exactly. Mr. Smart, do you think we are that safe with this Ebola thing?
No, we're not safer than any other part of the world. Well, let's go for a break and come back.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, welcome back to Straight Up. Ms. Joyce, are you there still?
Yes, sir. Mr. Small, yes, we have a lot of a billionaire with them black and them red passport and them private vehicle or them private whatever them use to transfer back and forward.
Yeah.
And if you go there and trouble them, say, never try to know if you have Ebola, they can sue you.
If you go here?
No, if the person who have a black passport,
yeah,
or a red passport,
yeah,
and your suspect say, well, him come by in private plane and he is in the area, maybe he have Ebola, you can't disturb him, you know? If you disturb him, he can sue you, because that is what on the passport they are not supposed to be searched.
But it's not that make PJ Patterson did sue a broadcast of it. I want to tell me, Mr. Small. Yes.
When I say something to you sometime to save the radio station,
oh,
just read between the lines.
What happened? Don't read it out between the lines.
Alright. Tell Mr. Fox that.
Yeah.
The child that he hear where I am looking after them some of the time when I am not at work. I am in and I am out, and when I get a little sore in a sore, tell Mr. Fox say, grant it me, yes, can come look for me, but then can they read me 24/7. Because I don't work.
Yeah,
I work and
yeah,
I don't pay no job and I don't
yeah
play dice.
Yes, me. Mr. Fox want to be one of your grandpits, eh?
No, you to find out which part of the pitney I'm at night every time I call the station.
You and him have some children?
He looks, sir. He looks, sir.
They're sour grip. Look here, Fox would say. Mind Fox tell people say your grip, so you know, lie. Him tell lie upon grip tree where him can.
All right, Mr. Small, have a lovely time. I'm going to hear Josh Bryce this long time. What happened to me, okay?
Yes, man, I'm good, man. I just want to hear him back, man.
Come all on. Right, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. Small.
Yes, welcome.
You know, I would love to just say congratulations to Mr. Sir Robinson. Who has been,
Justice Robinson.
Justice Robinson. Yes, you know, this goes to show that our legal minds are some of the best in the world. You know, this goes to show that we have the people here who to do the good works that is expected of us. Because everybody knows the Jamaican are people who is very talented and things. One thing I want to talk to you about, Mr. There is And the editorial in the Greener this morning, positive mortgage move. You know, I've been advocating for this for a long time, for the rate of mortgage to go down in HT, and the government is now doing it. In St. Elizabeth yesterday, a water catchment place was opened, you know, by the Minister of Water.
Who that?
Robert Pickersgill.
You mean Yap Yap?
I couldn't get the one to call the man, but
no, it's him. Him says so. Yap yap.
That is a part of passing the people's test.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. Those persons in Hanover, Trelawney, and Fenton who got tigers for land between Saturday and yesterday. That is another part of passing the people's test.
So you come back here, propaganda.
Empowering the people.
You come back here, propaganda.
Do those tiger.
All right, we have to go. No, if you're not come back here, propaganda, we have to go. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up. Hello. Welcome, Straight Up. Hello. Welcome.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Customer, attend there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Greetings, my brother.
Yes, sir.
That phone let like that bang. Not true.
Yeah, man.
You know, sir, the Maroon them get a radio station now.
Yes, sir.
The 36th radio station in Jamaica.
That's how many are so much, man?
Yes, man, me I tell you, man. But I can't upon all 36 of them.
No, no.
So when me upon Jerry Smart program, you know, say Jerry Smart program, a shock.
Oh.
You see me a chat with my brother?
And then when you go upon the program.
Well, yes, because I mean, I couldn't want program a shock. Not true.
No. But I can't tell where you go.
Yes.
A shock.
Well, when you go shock and couple more women ago can shock too. But I'm sure it's a report media shock. Like what happened down at the Netball Independent Park. You hear about it?
Independence Park?
Yeah, you know you hear about it.
Which part that? Which part in
the field? Where the netball field is at the National Stadium.
Gary, it's about name, you know.
You know, Independent Park, them call it, you know.
Yeah, it's about another name. Start with G.
Seen?
Yeah.
But what you think up now, since them fixed it the last time and laid the service and thing,
yeah.
Appear shocking, I go on down there, you know.
Yeah?
Yes. So they have to close it now and assess the whole thing.
Yeah.
Before any training can go on. So it doesn't affect the Sunshine Girls because younger they don't really have to train. And that's a shock from all the living, so. Okay, I come like under the earth. It will come from.
Yeah.
So through that about shock, we'll just drop in that tonight, you know?
Yeah.
But listen to me now. The land.
Yeah.
We learned that it is what? Just 180 million.
Yeah.
Which is 20 million per acre.
Yes.
What they did not purchase are the copyrights,
yeah,
and thing to total ownership of the business, which they say would cost an additional $20 million.
Yeah.
So therefore, according to the Prime Minister, the money that they spent was just on land. And when you talk about land at 20 million per acre, boy, I can't small people ever live on that. You see, my David? No, I don't know if there is any other information, but so far, that is what I am grasping. Now, if somebody else have other information, them can't just come and just say it. They must bring some form of evidence,
yeah,
to counteract that figure that we have there.
You mean like Sanginetti?
And anybody else like him who have that sort of information?
Yeah.
I'm not doubting them. But as I say, carry the evidence.
Yeah.
Let us know what is the position, because we really want to know, not true?
Yeah.
See? So, I just leave that there.
Thank you very much, Erica.
No, one more point. When I was at Camperdown, you see?
Yeah.
I was the first treasurer of the Key Club.
What you say?
Starting in 19, between 75 to 76.
Yeah.
At that point, it's only male student could be in the club.
Yeah. Oh, yes, sir.
However, I was not comfortable. But as a foundation brethren,
yeah,
it need certain people with status in the all of the things. My command knows, say, well, even if I pure man, you know, say,
you have a bit quick, though. You have a bit quick. So what you do?
Yes. Well, to be honest with you, I just humble myself, and it went through 2-3 couple of years. But eventually, they start to accept female students. It's a boy and girl thing now.
All right. Okay.
See my David?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Yes, sir. I'm so glad that Why, that is a shock, you know, by Don Drummond, but I didn't want the version where King City introduced it. So, boy, the shock kind of falls flat away. Anyway, good morning and welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Jerry!
Yes, sir.
Good morning.
Welcome.
I want to work for food, senatorship, or board member?
Board member? No, I work for chicken.
Which one am I work for? Which one am I work for? Because
none of them. I work for Chicken Party.
Chicken Party. Chicken Party, man.
No, I don't know what I said. Rain or fall and breeze or blow.
Breeze or blow. Chicken, you know what? They adore.
Chicken Party. Yeah.
They adore.
Chicken Party.
I'm not like that, man. But come on, man. You need to get out of here with that, man. We tired of that, man. Pop together.
Yeah, but it twang.
Hey, Jerry. What are you, man? Jerry.
Yeah.
Well, on there, is more Jamaica? Is there any puppet master in Jamaica?
Me don't know, man.
So, are is most Jamaican people is a puppet by default?
By default, well. Well, yeah.
Because them sell out the Calvary. They are paying them to come out and now 1 minute at 12 million, 1 minute at 20 million, the next minute is worth it, and then nobody know come my action. If it's 240 million in value,
yeah.
So why would him sell it for 180?
Yes, they know that. And why nobody no come at the action?
And I think say some trade unionists.
Yeah.
Big fat trade unionists. I tell Lenny look white off the top because he not sound like Lenny look white. He really attack out of him when I'm up.
You not sound like the original Lenny.
No, it's all like some trade unionists. Hey, me yeah. Say later on the avalanche, you know. Yeah. It's gonna be an avalanche coming down 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Later on, there'll be some argument to say they might bring out all the big ones later. They was so mad that them never get in a studio yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, the first thing them said, why they wish them did not studio because all them liars are going to come in a studio with them today.
Yeah, tell Lambert Brown run them out, man.
Well, I mean, you said it. I hear him yesterday.
Yeah.
And him said, why over the weekend with them pepper him want to come out, come. Him said, I'll put him out there with it, man. A big gun's coming out later.
Yeah.
UDC is being run. Now you DC, what you call it up? NHT by the head and the tail.
Alright, look here, where we're going now though. What do you mean? I got the, big guns.
The head and the tail, Dougie and the other man there.
Yeah.
You
know what I mean? Alright, before you get me in yeah. trouble. Thank you very much, yes, sir.
News Talk 93 FM. Heard everywhere.
Yes, welcome back to the straight up going down into the stretch here. And I just want to heal my bridging up in a compound town that Clive done. Because I hear say, you get the radio station up there. A bang, radio a bang. 88.7 on the Clive done up in a compound town. Got your own radio station now. A bang, radio. Text message. Good morning, Jerry. I love what you're doing. When weekend, I run out of patience just to hear you again on Monday. My partner introduced me to your program, and there are no regrets. Could you big him up for me? James at Michael, with all due respect. Love you, Jerry. Bless up. All right, big up James at Michael from your partner. Next one. Jerry, it would be better if Jamaica invited North American investors over the Chinese, because Chinese hire their own. Well, you know that the Chinese investors are pushing out around the world more than North American investors. Let us see. Next one. Bongo, does Lodge admit women in his association, coming from Security Everton of Kingston, Central Kingston? I'm not sure about the big Lodge, I mean, but I know the poor people Lodge. Most of the poor people Lodge from long time. I know some of the Lodges is the poor people join them. I can't remember, so I used to know some of them name by heart when I was a youth. I used to observe them thing very much. Friendly society and Lodge and burial scheme and all them thing. Most of the poor people Lodge have both admit both man and woman tonight. The poor people Lodge them. Different from the rich people Lodge. That's what I remember. Yes, get back to the phone. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Bongo Jerry.
Welcome, Master Black. What's going
on? I want to big up my brethren Garnet. You see, he's coming right through to what I'm saying now, so I love him for that.
Yes, sir.
I heard you say that something wrong, like when you respond to him, you say like I'm mixed up in my brain or something, like I'm having some kind of controversy
no.
in my own brain.
No,
what
no.
What does that mean?
No, man, you change up my word. You can't do that, man.
No, I say verbatim.
Well, or somebody tell you.
No, listen to you earlier.
Hear my words now.
Yeah.
I was saying that I hear that Asta Black have an internal dispute. Because, you know, the party not big and strong till it have internal dispute, you know.
No, mine won't have that.
So the PNP have internal dispute, but them work it out and...
Mine won't have an internal dispute, because if somebody don't agree with me, they take a walk. Because I am not going to run.
No, you mean
I
for somebody.
Where nobody, you have to march the same drum beat.
Yeah.
Do good. You know, you got being here, you learn to play the repeater.
Yes.
They say, do good.
Yes.
I mean, when they want to the Rasta man.
No, that's not the repeater.
Who say he never
no,
support a Rasta man like Asta Black
no.
in politics.
That's not the Peter, that's the Funde. It's the Funde that said do good.
And the Funde, I Funde too.
The repeater, are they one to repeat?
Yeah, man, you remember Bongo Daniel? Anyway, you make a mistake, you know, man. Take a jump from you, you know, man.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. No, boy, I must see you first make me bust out and laugh on the program, sir.
What you saying? Who will Jamaica laugh?
Anyone disagree with them of a walk?
What?
And you're the one, Dan. We are the highway, boy.
Hey, you have to use that nowadays, you know, because it's like some people just in there like the man, you know, the former president of the Marcus Garvey movement.
Which one?
They come in there. The PMP, why you send him to come tell people, say, me stealing Marcus Garvey's star from CBN TV?
Who that?
Miguel Long.
Yeah.
Then I hold on, but the past CBM, they talk about, say, me stole his star that belonged to all Jamaica. I tell him not to use Marcus Garvey name to destroy it again. And them still, they push it. They need to leave the hero alone. And what may plan the great smoke out. So everybody, no matter where they're in central Jamaica,
yeah.
Central Westmoreland, or the entire Jamaica, and the 29th,
yeah.
Start a fire, do something, set up some smoke thing to go on. Because we want smoke out corruption, smoke out chickpea, mosquito.
I smoke out the ham.
GLP, every one of them that corrupt.
Yeah, smoke out the ham. Yeah, smoke out the ham too.
Do?
Ham.
Why you keep, Bunga Jerry, you know it's everyone that.
Of course, that's what I said, then I smoke you.
I don't, but then I smoke. I don't deal with
but ham.
I don't stop people from using ham because
that
I don't want nobody to tell me say I can't smoke.
But really. That's what we're saying, smoking out the ham.
No, smoke out all bad man. Everything that is corrupt.
Exactly, and the ham too.
Well, if you look at some people respect and lovely and you go to some party Rastafari and they ham sell off faster.
I go to some party Rastafari and which kind of Rastafari party I sell off faster?
Well, the party was
never going to
celebrate.
Only
they have pork, the jerk pork. And that pork and that you talk about
the you know what I notice about Otamene?
Yeah, Otamene.
Yeah, the you know, see the other program where the Otamene slogan come from. That's why I know Daryl Braz is in the program, you know. Ah, yes, it's that. But,
imagine the PMP
but no, hold on, but me I say something.
Westmoreland Central and GLP, and none of them know how to debate Rastafari, like I want them, they're afraid.
But I want
to come through and talk Rastafari and make the people know who them getting, who them voting for. They know stand back.
But I can't get to say nothing for my own program.
Alright,
if I did register in Westmoreland, you have my vote. I got my vote.
You know that.
Alright, I go on here, sir. Straight.
Yes, I love.
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up, you know?
Yeah, Jerry.
Welcome, sir.
Why, I am listening to you, boy, and I am watching the international news, boy. You know that Bill Cosby is 77 years old.
Yeah, I know.
And a lot of ladies, boy, international news is telling a lot of things about him.
Yeah.
It don't sound good.
Yeah.
I guess I understand that he have a new program coming out on NBC.
I wonder if that's why them time it at this time, yeah.
But they are treating Bill Cosby like Herman Cain.
Herman Cain, that's how again.
That's a former candidate for the Republican Party, you know.
How them they treat him?
When he go to run for the Republican, a lot of ladies was coming out and say...
Oh, yes.
You know?
Say him raise Cain upon them.
Yeah. But Bill Cosby must come out and tell us the facts, man.
Yeah, but you say you said the same liar, said that was a long time ago. I doubt if any liar would have said that.
Yeah, man, you liar, say it's an old story that.
Oh, you mean it's an old story I'm telling? Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's an old story.
Alright, let's see you now. Catch you tomorrow.
Yeah, man, cool.
Morning, welcome, Straight Up, hello. Welcome, good morning. Let's go.
Hey, you know, let me ask you this today.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm going to give a suggestion.
Yeah.
What I'm gonna put the player all time menu.
Yeah.
The middle says the kids don't have nowhere to play, Jerry. Kids don't have nowhere to play, Jerry. You understand?
Yeah, so
then we make it in a park, a big park, where even the overseas club them can come around. Then I will put in all the athletes. In Gemini, swimming pool, diving pool, and Jerry, the old people, whether in them old, all ears, we all get some wheelchair for them, where them can come out and come enjoy the park, and them all put rides in there, and them all put shops, where them can rent, where them can make some money. You understand?
Yeah.
Yes, so me figure like say that is a good idea.
And you could have shock treatment there too.
Yes, yeah, you could have all kind of treatment there.
You would have take it? You would take it?
Yeah, man, I have one more thing to say today before I go.
Yeah.
You see Portia?
Yes, ma'am.
Portia.
Yeah.
She love you, you know?
That I get to find out, ma'am.
She love you, read about the car. You see Portia, you say, any of she never love you.
Yeah.
You come out for the radio already, but...
Oh. Tell me out. Hold on, tell me out. Tell me out.
Yeah, man.
Tell me out. Tell me out.
Any of us... Yeah,
any of us who?
Any of us... Tiago, I'm gonna ask you.
You mean blind? You mean blind?
You don't come out long time.
You mean blind?
I love Paul.
A blind Ziatak. No blind Ziatak. Yes, no blind Ziatak.
Yeah, Mr. Tiago, I'm gonna put you up long time.
Blind, but he put me on bus station 1964 in my youth, you know.
I'm not telling
you. Yeah, but we have a TV.
Yeah,
we have a TV program. We have a TV program on blinds. Two blinds, Buster blinds and Siaga blinds. The two of them make up and take we off fight after 2 weeks. You gone?
No, I'm there, man.
Alright, so you say you don't take the shock treatment, though? Alright, we better change your mind. Don't change your mind, alright. Alright, I forgot. Next call. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, you know?
Yes, Terry.
Yes, sir.
I was listening to you and Asa Black speaking a while ago.
Yeah, no, it's not Asa Black alone.
Was that.
Yeah.
If you're amongst him and there's any disagreement,
yeah,
you have to walk. is that still dictatorship?
Dictatorship. One man.
Yeah.
One man dictatorship.
Yeah, because
that that's not Tom Dick and Harry, you know.
Okay.
One man.
Okay, but then he must know now. And bring it to the public that if people are going to come to him to enlarge him what he's dealing with,
there
have to be room for persons to reason to agree to disagree.
Yes.
Because he may have ideas, I may have ideas, you may have ideas.
Yeah.
And we put them on the table and we agree to disagree till we can come to a conclusion. Not forever.
So that's what you think?
So, yeah, that's what I am thinking.
Yes.
That's why I am thinking it should go.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then, I mean, if that man are doing things, we can't stop him still.
Yeah.
And saying so.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think, as far as I am concerned, I think we should do things in a more open-minded way, you know?
And
because I may have some things. Yeah. Very small may have some things.
Yes. And let me close.
Go ahead.
And the main thing is, any association, the first thing to be agreed is that we are all equal. Well, thank you very much. I want to thank you. I want to thank my producer also, Tanya Richards. I want to also thank my production assistant, Kenisha Campbell, broadcast technician, Kevin Williams. Straight Up till tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. With the Midday News, I'm Errol Lee. Coming up in this newscast, Prime Minister to be faced with more out of many questions today. National Security Ministry urged to address current police pepper spray policy. St. Catherine Police make major breakthrough and meeting on the way to end strike by workers at the National Blood Bank.